Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn how to use the group by and summarize functions from the dplyr package. We use the group by and summarize functions when we want to aggregate our data potentially across different categories within a variable. Put more simply, if you want to do something like taking the average of a column, which is an operation that takes many values and reduces it to a single value, and possibly do this for specific groups, then you will be using group by and summarize. This schematic illustrates how the group by and summarize functions act on a tabular dataset that starts with n rows and p columns. You select the columns that will take part in the operation, whether it is a categorical variable that defines your groups, or these are the columns that will be used to compute some sort of summary value. You specify the type of summary you want to find, and after the operation is complete, you will be left with a new data frame containing one or more rows with L columns, where L is less than or equal to P. The number of rows you have is equal to the number of unique groups across the variables that you grouped over. The number of columns you have is equal to the number of summary operations you decide to run. The structure of the group by and summarize functions are as follows. The dataset gets piped into the group by function, provided you're using it. The function arguments for the group by function should be categorical variables within your dataset that you wish to use for creating groups. The group by function then gets piped into summarize for further processing. Much like the mutate function, the summarize function takes a keyword on the left, followed by an equal sign, and a computation on the right. The keyword to the left of the equal sign is what you want to name the new column within the data frame that gets returned to you. The computation on the right makes use of aggregating functions applied to one or more columns within the dataset to compute a summary value. There are a set of special functions that you can use to perform data aggregations in tandem with group by and summarize. Here we list a few of the common ones that you will use during the course. The first function listed here is the n function. We use this function to count the number of rows within a group. This function takes no inputs and was illustrated on the previous slide. Next is the sum function. For numerical variables, using this with summarize will add all the values within the column together. If combined with group by, then the sums are performed within each group. Similar to the sum function are the statistical functions mean, median, SD, which is short for standard deviation, min, which is short for minimum, and max, which is short for maximum. These functions compute these statistical values over a column of values when combined with summarize. When also combined with group by, then the statistical summaries are performed within the defined groups. Finally, you can perform counts and proportions of logical values, which is kind of like combining filter with summarize in a single line. The first example, sum x greater than 10, will count the number of values within a column that have a value of x greater than 10. The second example, mean y double equals 0, will tell you the proportion, or fraction, of values in the y column that are equal to 0. We now move into RStudio server for a screencast demoing how you can use the group by and summarize functions to manipulate the presidential dataset. Our examples will make use of the elected_pres2 version of the presidential dataset that we created in the mutate function tutorial. If you have not watched that tutorial yet, then you should go and watch that video before continuing with this one. Our first task will involve computing some summary information about the presidents in the database. We will do this by using only the summarize function, which means we are summarizing information about the full dataset. We start by writing the name of our modified dataset, elected_pres2. We pipe this into the summarize function. We will be creating several summaries. Just like with the mutate function, we start by providing a column name. Our first summary operation will be to count the number of rows in the dataset. We name this column count. We then type equals, followed by the n function. This function counts the number of rows. Note that it has no inputs. Then we type a comma. Our next summary will be to see what year does the first chronological president in the dataset start his first term. We type first_year equals min year start. The year function comes from the lubridate package and picks out the year value from the full date in the start column. Then we type comma. Our next summary will be to see the date that the last president in the dataset left office. We name this summary column last underscore year. We type equals, then max year end. Our next summary is the number of presidents in the dataset that belong to the Democratic Party. We type num underscore dems equals, then sum, party double equals Democratic, which is given in quotes. Then we type comma. Our next summary is to see how many years have all the presidents in the dataset served in office combined. We name this summary column year, then type equals, then sum term underscore length. Our last summary is to compute the average term length of all the presidents in the dataset. We name this column AVG underscore term underscore length, then type equals, then mean term underscore length. We execute the code block by pressing the green play button and see the resulting table. We now have our summary. There are 11 rows in the dataset. The first year of the earliest president in the dataset is 1953. The last year of the last president in the dataset is 2017. The number of Democratic presidents in the dataset is 5. The number of consecutive years covered by the presidents in the dataset is 64. And the average term length is 5.82 years. Our next task will rerun the analysis, but grouping over the party column. We copy and paste the code from the previous block to reuse. Then, we create a new line between elected underscore pres 2 and the summarize function. Here we write group by party to indicate that we want to rerun this analysis, but within the groups defined in the party column. We then write another pipe to make sure that the information is passed to summarize. Otherwise, everything is left the same. We click the green play button to execute the code. We get the resulting table. Comparing with what we had before, we now have two rows instead of one, representing the Democratic and Republican parties. We interpret the outputs as follows. The dataset contains 5 Democratic presidents and 6 Republican presidents. The earliest Democratic president in the dataset started in 1961, and the earliest Republican president started in 1953. The last year for the last Democratic president in the dataset was 2017, and the last year for the last Republican president in the dataset was 2009. The number of Democratic presidents in the Democratic Party category is 5, while in the Republican Party category is 0, which is to be expected. The number of years served by the Democratic presidents in the dataset is 28, and for the Republican presidents it is 36. The average term length for presidents in the Democratic Party in the dataset is 5.6 years, and 6.0 years for presidents in the Republican Party in the dataset. Finally, while it's not a function from the dplyr package, we should save our modified version of the presidential dataset that we have created in the mutate function lecture. We do this using the write underscore CSV function that comes from the reader package and is automatically loaded with tidyverse. We pipe our modified dataset, elected underscore pres 2, into the function write underscore CSV. Inside the argument for write underscore CSV, we write, quote, presidential underscore updated dot CSV, close quote, which is the name of the file we are saving to. When we run this code block, notice that it creates a new file that we can see in our file browser on the lower right of the screen. We can now load and interact with our updated dataset whenever we'd like. To do this, we can load the file using the function read underscore CSV. We choose a name to assign the loaded dataset into, for example, imported underscore presidential. Then we type the assigned symbol, less than hyphen, followed by read underscore CSV, and then the exact same name as the file, which is, quote, presidential underscore updated dot CSV, close quote. We run this block. Our modified dataset is now ready for use. We just need to use the word imported underscore presidential to use it.